The illicit trade of human lives is happening right under our noses every day. It is primarily affecting the lives of millions of women and children. Today, human trafficking is the second largest and fastest growing criminal enterprise in the world. Sexual exploitation, forced labor, and illegal organ trafficking are the hallmarks of an industry worth $150 billion per year. Every July 30th is dedicated to highlight the menace with the hope of curbing the activities. The focus this year is centered around first responders. And joining us to talk more on this day is Abraham Tamrat, who is the Program Manager, Migration Management Unit of IOM. Good to have you, Mr. Tamrat.
Yes, I can hear you.
Excellent. Thank you so very much for being with us. Now, let's go quickly into the matter. Why the focus on first responders this year?
During this period, despite the fact that several of our activities, day-to-day life, have been affected and pretty much put on hold throughout our lives, day-to-day lives, the issue of trafficking and the exploitation in flight of the victims had not really stopped. So that's why the first responders, people who are involved in the identification, assistance, and seeking justice for these victims, these first responders, be it government counterparts or civil society organizations and others, have not really stopped. They are putting their lives at risk to try and identify, to try and assist these victims and, of course, prosecute the traffickers. So it is in recognition of this risk that they are taking to ensure that the continuity of the services are there that this year's theme was channeled towards that.
Right. Now, trafficking in persons seem to have been relegated to the background, if you like, due to the COVID-19 pandemic. What's the plan to draw stakeholders' attention still to it this year?
That's why this year's World Day Against Trafficking has been actually channeled to sensitize the various stakeholders, starting from the government agencies to the donor community, to actually still be reminded that despite what is happening at the forefront of every media and others, the situation of trafficked victims is not really getting easier. As we speak, the resources and the efforts that we were actually putting out there are being reinforced to make sure that the plight of trafficked victims are actually put out there, be it in getting coverage, media coverage, as well as programmatic attention. As we speak, we have reignited, for example, as IOM and working with the federal government, we reignited the efforts that were technically, let's say, affected due to these travel restrictions in actually rescuing and bringing back migrants, trafficked victims among them. For example, over the past 3 days, more than 270 Nigerians were actually rescued and brought back from transit locations such as Mali and Niger. So we are rechanneling these efforts. We are giving it enough attention to make sure that it doesn't get left behind.
Mm-hmm. I mean, with the travel restriction as a result of COVID-19, has it in any way curbed the activities of these outlaws and, you know, traffickers?
That's a good point, and that's a kind of, let's say, misperception that we try and address throughout our sensitization efforts. This situation has made it quite difficult. Most of the time, trafficking networks flourish whenever the attention of government and other actors actually is channeled towards something else. Whenever there is a crisis, whenever there is such a pandemic of great magnitude, at diverts the attention towards that area and leaves a vacuum for them to actually do whatever they need to do to actually continue to exploit people. During this period, what we have recorded and noticed is that the exploitation of people, vulnerability of these victims of trafficking has increased significantly. Although travels cross borders have actually reduced because of and are affected because of this, the fact that people continue to be recruited, the fact that people continue to be exploited has not really reduced. It's quite the contrary. That's basically the information that is showing us, and people are actually finding themselves in a very difficult situation where they cannot move, they cannot access services throughout the transit and destination countries. So it has made it worse. This pandemic has made it worse for victims of trafficking and for vulnerability of people on the irregular migration route to be further end up in a trafficking situation.
Wow, that's quite unfortunate. Abraham Tamrat of IOM, thank you so very much for your thoughts and your contributions. And do keep safe out there as well.
Thank you so much.
All right, thank you so much.